Hi, this is Marty Kramer with the Texas Association of Realtors, here today with Lori Levy, Legislative and Regulatory Counsel at the Texas Association of Realtors, and that means she's one of our attorneys, frequently on the legal hotline fielding questions from Texas Realtors. And one of the things I know that you lawyers get questions on is timing regarding the contracts. So I wondered if you could tell people how timing is counted, how days are counted in contracts, and when those days start.
That's a great question. The timing in the TREC residential contracts is calendar days, so every single day counts, regardless of whether it's Saturday, Sunday, or a legal holiday. Every day counts for the deadlines in the contract. And as far as when those deadlines begin, for example, the option period, the contract says within blank days of the effective date. So let's say you put 10 into the contract, 10 days, it's going to be day one is the day after the effective date because it says within 10 days after the effective date. So you start counting the day after that all the way up to 10.
And on the day when that period ends, it ends at 11:59, is that correct?
That's right.
I thought I'd heard you lawyers saying that, right. Now, what happens if somebody can't meet one of those deadlines, they miss the deadline, or if a realtor has a client who might not be able to meet one of those deadlines?
If there is a deadline that the buyer or seller misses, they're going to be in breach of the contract, and the other party at that point could take legal action. If there is a deadline that's coming up, let's say the option period is about to end and the buyer hasn't gotten their inspections done, they would want to request an amendment to the contract to extend that option period. Otherwise, they're going to lose the right to terminate that contract. Having said that, let's say the buyer did get their inspections done and they've submitted an amendment for repairs to the seller, and they're on the last day of the option period. If that buyer has not heard back from the seller, they're going to have to make a decision whether they want to terminate the contract or possibly risk moving forward without that amendment. Just because there's an amendment on the table doesn't do anything to the deadline that's in the contract.
Very good. And one final question for you regarding timing and contracts, and that is, if a buyer makes an offer, how long does the seller have to respond to that offer?
There is nothing in the law that puts a time limit on the seller responding to an offer. That's the same for a buyer. Whichever party puts an offer on the table, it's out there until the other party either accepts it or rejects it, or the party that made the offer could rescind it if they got tired of waiting on a non-responsive party.
Thanks for those answers, Lori. And if anybody has additional questions, they can always call the Texas Association of Realtors Legal Hotline.